morning. Thanks for tuning in. Well, the local share market's going to be under renewed pressure this morning. The futures are saying the ASX 200 will be down by a half of 1%. So coming on the back of yesterday's sizable decline, which had the index down by more than 1.3%, the question is, having fallen by the most part of 2% in one and a bit days, whether or not that is enough to at least see the sellers hold up a little bit, or whether or not there's something more left in the tank. We continue to see weakness in commodity prices overnight, and there was also weakness where banking names were concerned. So they will remain features of today's trade to some extent. So in terms of what we saw on Wall Street, there was a bit of a contrast between what we saw with the three leading indices. The Dow Jones was down by a third of a percent. So that in part reflected weakness where financial stocks were concerned. The S&P 500, by contrast, only managed an improvement of a quarter of a percent. But what stood out within its performance was that the technology benchmark was up by more than a percent and hitting a record high in the process. That was also reflected in the fortunes of the Nasdaq, which was up by around 0.9%. The Philadelphia Semiconductor Index was just in positive territory, and there were mixed outcomes in terms of that index. We saw a little bit of weakness where Nvidia shares were concerned, advanced micro devices, so two of the more favored names in the chip space, that down by about 0.75%. Less favored names, Broadcom and Marvell Technology, were up by more than a percent. So a little bit of rotation there, with the index not moving ahead terribly much. What did stand out was Apple. So Apple shares rose by 7%, the market seeming to be encouraged by the latest update in relation to artificial intelligence and what that will mean for product launches down the track for Apple. The belief being that we're all going to ditch our old phones, buy new phones. That's exactly what investors like in terms of the organizations that they're favoring. Elsewhere, the other important aspect of last night's trade was what happened with long-term interest rates in particular. So a 10-year government bond fell by 6 basis points to 4.40%. So you've heard me talk often about the line in the sand when it comes to these bond yields. And last night, to see the bond auction that took place on the part of the US Treasury selling $39 billion worth of 10-year government bonds, that was swallowed up by investors. So on the eve of an inflation result, with the CPI figures coming down the pipe in the next day, and indeed the conclusion of the US Fed's policy setting meeting, that's a pretty bold statement to see investors step up and buy that amount of government bonds under the circumstances. There have been suggestions that this is a view on how benign the inflation numbers might be, and indeed the US Fed sticking to its rhetoric that there are rate cuts coming down the pipe, even though there have been some flies in the ointment when it comes to recent inflation outcomes. So a fascinating window of time is before us in terms of the next day and a half. So it'll be interesting to see whether or not those bond buyers will be vindicated with the conviction that they showed at that Treasury auction overnight. Elsewhere, as far as European markets were concerned, I should mention that US financials were under a deal of pressure. The KBW Bank Index down by about 2%. Citibank shares fell by the lion's share of 4%, 3.7%. JPMorgan down by more than 2.5%. Bank of America was down by about 2% as well. So the weakness for US financials was also emulated where European indices were concerned. They were at the heart of the declines across European markets. The FTSE in London was down by 1%, the French market down 1.3%, the German DAX was down 0.2%, and the Stocks 600 index was down by almost 1%. So as I said, the element that united the performance of US and European stocks overnight was the weakness in banking stocks. The French bank, Société Générale, down by about 5%. Banque Nationale de Paris, Paribas, down by about 4%. Italian bank, UniCredit, down 4%. Deutsche Bank was down by around 3%. Spanish bank, Banco Santander, was down by about 2%. So the political uncertainty that has been thrown up by the European parliamentary elections at the weekend continues to reverse reverberate through the financial space in Europe. And so it's a question of to what extent that continues in the near term. You're even seeing that reflected in the bond market. So you're seeing French government bonds sell off quite aggressively, and investors are then favouring German bonds as a result because of the divergent financial picture between those two countries, the Germans being in a better financial position than the French, and that's being reflected in the spreads between German and French government bond yields. So the other aspect of trade in the last day has been the weakness in commodity prices, which will be a factor in the way that the local share market performs today. We saw a substantial decline yesterday in the materials space. That index was the leading decliner, down by more than 2%. So it's a question to what extent that is still seen negatively. We've seen copper prices fall away to a 7-week low in the last day, down by about 0.75%. Iron ore prices at a 2-month low, having fallen by 1% overnight, and aluminium prices at a 1-month low as well. So, and part of the reason that you're seeing this weakness in commodity prices, the softer manufacturing numbers that have emerged in the last day where China is concerned. So we saw weakness in mining stocks in the Northern Hemisphere. Gold was largely flat. However, you know, it has fallen quite substantially over the course of recent days and has shown little inclination to rally. There were some upgrades from the Energy Information Agency in the United States in relation to 2024 consumption forecasts, which played a part in oil prices improving by about 0.25% to just short of $78 a barrel. So there might be some glimmers of hope where the local energy sector is concerned today. But again, we'll be focusing on Chinese economic news today in the form of consumer and producer inflation numbers. And the risk here is that we see lower readings. So wherever we're looking at inflation numbers elsewhere, we kind of want the heat to be coming out of them, but it would actually be welcome to see a little more inflation in the picture where China is concerned. So that's something to keep in mind today. Origin will be holding an investor day. There are not too many other highlights as far as the corporate picture is concerned today. The Aussie dollar, well, it's been as low as 65.80 in that neighbourhood, and it's bounced a couple of times off that level. But the question is whether or not it can hold on to that neighbourhood given the weakening commodity picture that we're seeing at the moment. So it's above 66 US cents. It's just a question of whether or not it runs into more headwinds in the next day. Have a good day. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.